Hey everyone, happy Sunday or whatever a day it might be for you. Hope you're having a great week and a great day, and glad you are joining us on this video for Missions and Me. We've been talking about Missions and Me these past couple weeks, and this is week four now of Missions and Me. And just as a reminder, we're always meeting here live in the arena on Sunday mornings at 10 o'clock. But if you can't join us yet, we are glad you're joining us here on video. And so if you've joined us for the last few weeks, you'll know that Miss Priscilla is teaching us three verses. We're learning Psalm 96:3, we're learning John 3:16, and we're learning Matthew 28:19 and 20. So here's Miss Priscilla to teach you those two verses, and a video, a song that we've been learning to teach you the verse for Matthew. Here they are.
Let's try it. Here we go. Then we'll go right in and we're playing it on our lap. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous deeds among all peoples. Psalm 96:3. Okay? Remember, we're going to say, ready, hit it. Okay? I'm going to kind of stand here so I can get the motions. Here we go. Ready, hit it. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. John 3:16. Oh, you guys are good. One more time. Let's do it. Ready, hit it. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
All right, I hope you're learning those things. Those are great verses to learn. And so every week we're saying these three things as we start talking about Missions and Me. Number one, missions lets us see how God is at work in places all over the world. Today we're going to go to one of those places. Missions lets us see how God shows people who Jesus is. And finally, missions lets us see how much God loves people everywhere. So, and every week we have Miami Missions Point, MMP, and the first week we said God can use anyone and anything to tell others about him, and he used Bruce Olson in Colombia. He used a banana to tell the people about Jesus that Bruce was working with. I'm not going to tell his story. If you didn't catch it, you got to go back, watch that video. The second week we said God can use whatever we give him to teach others about him. And he used Sarah Boardman, who lost her husband, lost two of her children. She only had her one baby with her, but she decided to stay in Myanmar and teach the people. And then last week we said, God helps people have perseverance to not give up when life is difficult. And we learned about Horace Underwood in Korea. And we learned about the difficulty it is for people who are in North Korea, especially the people there who love Jesus, and how we need to be in praying for them and God protecting them and giving them perseverance. Well, today we're talking about this Miami Missions Point. God will provide all that we need for telling others about Jesus. And we're going to talk about an amazing story. But usually we talk about who first. Today we're going to say where first, and the where is going to be England. Have you ever been to England? It's a terrible English accent, but we're going to England today. So this is Europe. This is the area of Europe, of the world, and up here, this little island area is the United Kingdom, and as a part of that is this island here called England, and we're going to a place in England called Bristol. It's a city there, and England is about the size of the state of Louisiana, just for comparison. So it's not ginormous, but it's not a tiny little place either. But there's a lot of people there, 53 million people. That's a lot of people in that place. And so as we talk about what happened in the country of England, you could easily find things. You might even know things about the country of England. So today we're going to talk about somebody in England. God will provide all that we need for telling others about Jesus. And this person, you might not think of a missionary because we've been talking about people who have gone far away from where they grew up or far away from their homes. This person didn't go far away necessarily, but he ministered to a group of people that had need. And God opened the door for him to help these people. And God laid it on his heart and did amazing things to make that happen. So the who is this man, George Mueller. How about that cool beard? I wish I could grow a beard like George. But George Mueller is the guy we're talking about today. Now, you all, this is cool. When George Mueller was a young boy growing up in Germany, he was a bad guy. He even stole money from his own parents. Anybody out there ever done that? I hope not. George was a bad kid, you know. But he went to college, and while George was in college, he started following Jesus. And then he moved back to London, England. Not moved back to, he moved to London, England after college. And so at age 27, George began to preach in Bristol. He began to build an orphanage in the city of Bristol. And so here's the cool thing. He ended up with 5 orphanage homes. We're going to see pictures of those in a little bit. But he had over 2,000 kids in his orphanages. That's a lot of kids. The coolest part about George Mueller has to do with today's Miami Missions point. In over 60 years of ministry, George Mueller never asked anyone for anything. He didn't ask for money. He didn't ask for food. He didn't ask for anything for his orphanages to get them all built. He only prayed. It's an amazing story. We're going to watch a video about it here live. You can watch this video too. There's a link down below. It's a VeggieTale movie about George Mueller's life. And so you get an idea of just how some of those things happened with George Mueller. Click the link below. Be sure to come back to finish up with us on today's Missions of Need. We'll see you in a bit. What a story, huh? Amazing story. And there are other different movies about George Mueller too. If your parents get on Right Now Media, there are other movies about George Mueller, longer ones that tell more about his story too. But here's a picture. Someone drew this a long time ago, but here's some of George's, this is where his buildings were and what some of them looked like. And you even can go today. They were built so well back in the day, and whatever happened around them, they kept the buildings, and they're still being used today, I think, for apartments or maybe a college dorm. But the buildings were so good and so amazingly built, they still use them today. Now, the kids that were in George's orphanages didn't just go to school. You saw all that land there that was around the orphanage buildings. They learned to work. They worked hard. And they learned about farming. They learned about so many different things. But most of all, they learned about Jesus. And they were cared for and they were loved. And God did amazing things in the lives of so many kids as George Mueller ministered to them. And as George Mueller prayed and never asked for a thing, God always provided for him. God will provide all that we need for telling others about Jesus. So today's what has to do with what we need. And you think about, well, what do you need? What do you need for living for a day? What do you need to survive for a day? When we talk about what we need, I always like to talk about outside stuff versus inside stuff. Outside stuff versus inside stuff. Because we need both. And so the outside stuff, that's kind of easy, right? You need food, you need clothes, you gotta have clothes, especially if it's cold outside like it has been. You need shelter, you gotta have a place to live. You need protection, right? You might need transportation. You might have to get around or get to school. Your mom or your dad, they need a job. They've got to earn money to be able to pay for a lot of these things. And you could probably think of other things. You could make this list longer of outside stuff that you need to live, right? That's pretty easy. What about the inside stuff? That's a little bit different. Now, can you survive without some of these inside things? Well, sure, your body can survive, but God didn't make us just for our bodies to survive. Inside of us, we have a heart, we have feelings, and we have thoughts, and we have things we think about. And so God made those things to have needs as well, like love. It's important for us to know that we are loved, that someone cares for us, that someone is there for us. We need encouragement. We need someone to tell us we're doing a good job or that we're important to them. We need peace in our lives. And I'm not just talking about peace as in if you live in a place where there's war in your country. I mean, that's important too. But there are a lot of people who inside of their hearts, their feelings, and in their minds, their thoughts, just go into all kinds of confusion and difficulty, and they don't have peace on the inside. And so that's just as important as peace on the outside. Understanding. Maybe you're confused about something you feel, or about something you think, or about something that happened. We all need someone to understand us and to help us understand what's going on with life. We need joy. God made us to have joy. And not just a kind of a happiness that we're happy about something for a little while, but deep joy because of a lot of other these other things in our lives. God gives us joy because we know that He's with us and we know that He provides these things. Security. We need to know that someone's going to look out for us and someone's going to help us and to be there for us. And again, it's not just protecting our bodies on the outside, but it's protecting us, our hearts and our minds as well. Relationship. God didn't make us to be alone. He made us to be in relationship with other people. And we need friends and we need family. We need people to be around us to help us through life and to encourage us and to pick us up when things get difficult and for us to be able to help them as well. Purpose. Why are we even here? A lot of people ask that question. Why am I on this earth? And if we don't know what a purpose is, if we forget that God made us to know Him and to glorify Him and that He has amazing things for us, life can be really meaningless and difficult. Freedom. Nobody wants to be locked up in a cage. Nobody wants to have their freedom taken away from them. Freedom is an important thing that's on the inside and really on the outside too. You could probably add to this list, right? There's lots of other things that you could probably think of that are inside stuff things that we need to live, that we need to survive. This might be a good time you could pause the video, talk about that with your family right now, but this is one of those things. So we're talking about inside stuff that we need and outside stuff that we need, and talking about the fact that God provides those things for us. I mean, if you look at that list, those two lists, you think about those things, we have clothes. Hopefully you have food. You're watching this video. If you are from your home, you have a mom or a dad. Maybe you have brothers and sisters. You have security. You have peace. Those are things that we don't want to take for granted. And we want to thank God for whenever we think about them. But you know what? It's not just about us and what we have. You know, God made us that we can help others too. And so someone you know, is there someone you know, maybe they need something outside stuff or inside stuff that you might be able to help them with. Maybe it's a word of kindness. Maybe it's a hug. Maybe it's a smile. Maybe it's something on the outside that you're able to help them with, okay? So someone you know, this is the big question for the week. Not just remembering and being thankful for all the outside stuff and inside stuff that God does for us, but how can we help someone else out who maybe has a need of outside stuff or inside stuff that we can help them with? Here's a great verse about God providing. This is Philippians 4:19, and it says, "And my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of His glory in Christ Jesus." My God will meet all your needs according to His great, amazing riches. Outside stuff, inside stuff, God will meet our needs. We can trust Him. We know that He's going to provide for us. And I hope that that helps you every time you think about the things that you have. All those things on both lists, that you would just say a prayer. Thank you, God. Thanks for being so good. Thanks for providing for me. So the why. The why, we're going to pray for orphans today. You could probably get a map out and look at pretty much any country in the world, put your finger on it, read the name of it, there are going to be orphans there. There are going to be kids there who don't have parents. There are going to be kids there who, a lot of places, they just live on the street. They don't even have a place to live. And so we want to pray for orphans today. And I hope as you think about those lists, inside stuff, outside stuff, and you think about the things that God has given you, you'll think to pray for orphans. You'll think to pray for kids that don't have those things like you do. So we want to pray that God will provide for orphans. There are people all over the world trying to help kids who are orphans, kids who live on the streets, to provide for them a place for them to live, hopefully, someone to care for them, food, education. So we want to pray that God will provide for them. And we pray that God would help those people who are trying to help the orphans. We want to pray that God would protect them. Lots of evil things that are out there, and especially for a little kid, maybe someone your age who's living out on the street, maybe they're by themselves. We want to pray that God would protect them from being hurt, from someone taking them away, all kinds of things. So we pray that God would protect them. We want to pray that God would give them peace. Can you imagine how scary it would be to not have a home, not have parents, to have to live on your own and out in the world? We want to pray that God would somehow give them peace and help them find the help that they need. And then we want to pray that God would help us to remember to pray. When we remember the good things that God has given us, our families, our homes, the things that we have on the inside, love and peace and encouragement, we want to think, hey, I know there are people in this world, there are kids in this world, God, who don't have those things, and I pray you would help them. And you know what? Maybe someday, one of you, you're going to grow up and God's going to call you. God's going to give you opportunity to help orphans somewhere. That could happen. I think it might. So today, God will provide for us all that we need for telling others, excuse me, about him. So I hope that you've been encouraged. I hope you enjoyed George Mueller's story today. I hope if you find yourself in need, you will trust God. You will pray. Trust that God will provide. Look up that verse again, Philippians 4:19. Most of all, we pray you're doing well. We miss you if you're not able to be with us, and we understand if you're not, but we hope to see you soon. We would love to know how you're doing. If your mom or dad have questions about what we're doing or you want to tell us how you're doing, you can always email us at kids@faclex.com, or you can find us on social media, and we will see you next week. We're going to head back to somewhere close to where we went today. And be sure to wear your green. Okay? Have a great week. We'll see you next time, friends.